About Chris Pratt as Garfield?
Yes, yes. I will be honest with you. I love Chris Pratt, of course, but I was very disappointed that that they're using someone other than myself as Garfield. That was kind of shocking, and I'm surprised, but then again, you know, it happens in the business. It's happened to me before. Fortunately, Transformers have come back, so I'm doing Megatron. That's good. But yeah, that was a little disappointing.
See? Two. Just for us.
Well, I have told the story before, but when I was trying to come up with a voice for Megatron, I had this deep voice that I played with that was actually started as an impression of Barry White. Probably a lot of you don't know who Barry White is. He was the singer of Love, and he used to sound kind of... Such a big, powerful, funny voice to me, because I was just a kid going,
oh, my God, it's funny.
It's scary. But anyhow.
Oh, you want to buy two more? You're missing two. How do I know you didn't eat them?
So I love that voice, and I started kind of fiddling with it.
Dr. Claw.
Yeah, and I used it for Dr. Claw and for...
I'll get you, Gadget, if it's the last thing I do, Gadget!
And then I need 2 dozen mints, 15 pinks, 11 whites, and 16 boxes, and then it starts to get complicated. 13 blue ones, 8 green ones, 1 black and white one, in however many boxes.
George.
4 reds, 5 whites, 6 blues, 19 purple dot triangly ones, and 53 cylinders evenly distributed in small boxes. Then one
George.
Blue ones
individually
wrapped with tiny green ribbons. Happy Arbor
features, a Disney feature, The Cave of Wonders.
He who enters the Cave of Wonders, beware.
But when I was trying to think of something different for Megatron, because I know that there's other actors who do low voices. Just blue voice. I can't do him. I know he's doing me.
Yes. He did you last year.
I am working on him. I am working on him.
Roll out.
But I will get him. I will get him. Maybe not the soul, but enough to irritate him.
Soundwave superior. Constructicons inferior. Soundwave superior. Autobots inferior.
This, you know, one of the really fun things about being here, for both of us, I'm speaking for Peter too, but we love the accents. And we love your accents. They're just fantastic. I mean, USA is like, but here it's like, and so many and so varied and beautiful. I mean, they're just wonderful. So I thought you said, what would Megatron's pizzas be like?
Even Scooby-Doo?
Me? Don't worry, there's no way our voices come from some guy named Frank.
Is Frank Welker up there?
You insolent organics! You failed in your mission! Thanks to your incompetence, my plan has failed! Terracons! I want those Autobots torn into so many pieces that we couldn't even sell them as junk to the junkyards! Now we will finish the Autobots! Under Galvatron's rule! You dropped it, didn't you?
Hey, Garfield here. Michelle and Steven are way too busy.
Here's something to keep you warm! I will build the ultimate weapon to defeat the Autobots, to control the planet, to conquer the universe!
There was a thing that I did that was actually, I called it my cave voice, and I see if I can do it for you. I'm trying to do like maybe 11 different sounds at the same time. So,
hello, I am the Cave of Wonder. Where are you?
She said, Lieutenant Sheep.
Buck Bacaw, Buck Buck. Buck Bacaw, Buck Buck Bucky, Buck Bacaw. Oh, wait. Then she went back and changed Bacaw Buck Buck to Buck Buck Bacaw.
As I suspected, she's changing her story.
Orson, you have got to do something about Roy here.
Hey, here comes Booker chasing another worm.
Oh, no, I gotta play a worm now?
I'm Booker, I'm Sheldon, and here's our hurricane. We love to sing and dance.
That's a big if, Egon. According to Who's Who in the spirit world, the Ghostmaster rates as a class 11.
11?
Right. Even if we could use our traps and throwers, we can never hold him. You find that most of the guys who do voices in the cartoons can do many impressions of people and sounds and all that, but other cartoon characters I do...
I do Baby Kermit on the Muppet Babies.
I'm Skeeter, but I forget Skeeter, now she's a little girl, and he never mentions her because he's a male chauvinist frog.
Yeah, I guess I am a male chauvinist frog.
I took a circus arts class last summer.
Why am I not surprised? And what did you learn?
I worked out on the trapeze a bit, but I ended up breaking a lot of bones.
You seem to have healed well.
What? Oh, not my bones. I was supposed to catch this guy and I dropped him onto someone. And they both fell into some other people.
That's terrible.
Who hit the tent support, which tipped the popcorn cart, which set fire to the audience risers, which collapsed with 48 people sitting on them.
This is how you make a lion's roar. And it's better with a waste paper bag so you put your head under it. And you can do underwater sounds like this. You just take your finger and put it in between your lips. And now you're underwater. Dogs or pigs.
Oh,
I spend most of my time doing voiceovers. It's fun, it's fast, and it's furious. And another great thing that voice people really enjoy is that when you're an on-camera actor, usually you get stuck with doing one role or whatever your physiognomy restricts you to. But here, like on Ghostbusters, I mean, you can come in and you can be a little dog. And
you can be like one of these guys.
Or you can even be a person with 12 voices. Now, on camera, you can't quite get away with that, you know. So this is, for an actor, it's a tremendous thing to be able to play bad guys, good guys, and all in the same show.
Oh, he is. Shake. Bang.
Like, please, please, please.
Good boy.
No, it was. But I did learn a valuable lesson about the trapeze.
Which was?
Don't drop people. Oh, and don't fall.
Yes, those are kind of the basics. How would you like a junior, second assistant backup trapeze position?
It would be an honor, sir.
So that's why lemon lime flavors go together.
They're both sour.
My G1 voice now began to have to transform into more of a larger voice. I am Megatron.
But
kind of like an iceberg trying to make its way to the
Your stay of execution has come to an end.
Sorry, Prime. The ship was full.
Well, the name on the crate says Jameson Hive White, Professor of Archaeology, London, England. Well, gang, it looks like we're up to our armor plates in another mystery.
Would anyone wants human to go home?
Yeah, that'd be all right with me, too.
Megatron, he's after something Jaeger had.
Soul. That is why I have no faith.
mini meatball or I'll step on you. You and what on you, maxi turkey?
Who's talking, Thundercracker?
Hey, I didn't volunteer for this geeky assignment. I want Skywalk's job. But a frenzy. Geekworks made for a geek. Like you.